So I am a student. I study biotechnology. I'm from Greece. I live in Athens.
Oh, cool.
I haven't applied. That's a bad story, but I haven't applied yet for a job.
Gotcha.
I would like to do it. I would like to do it, but I haven't. How do you propose to start?
Are you still there? To delete your message, press 7. To save it in the archives, press 9. To hear more options, press 0.
Data Leap, thank goodness you're here, because today I have an important announcement. Today we're going to start to understand where the Data Leap community is coming from, and that's going to involve helping you get to know your peers, your Data Leap peers. If we haven't had the pleasure of meeting yet, my name is Andrew from Data Leap, and this is a channel where we are talking to academic students and professionals sick and tired of their industry and wanting to move away into data science, a industry that pays six figures in the baseline here in Silicon Valley, California. Today is your inaugural chance to meet your Data Leap peers, and you are gonna talk today to Rhea. She is a student working in Athens, Greece, and she has been an aspiring data scientist, and she came from the world of bioinformatics. If you want to see how other data scientists have transitioned through that field, I have an interview with the data professor himself, a professor of bioinformatics. But today is all about Rhea, so let's move into our interview and see what she has to say. Thanks for staying all the way to the end in advance. Peace. How's it going? Good to meet you. My name is Andrew. I am an educator on YouTube. I'm a data scientist here in Silicon Valley and a coach and a mentor. I've had 30 different interviews here in this space and competing offers every single time. I move from industry to industry, hedge funds to startups to FAANG companies. And now I have a feeling in the pandemic, there are people that want to also get into this space. So I'm here to answer any questions you might have.
Nice to meet you, Andrew. So I am a student. I study biotechnology. I'm from Greece. I live in Athens.
Oh, cool.
You had Santorini.
Santorini, yes, I love this. I love Greece.
Yeah, so I am a student, and by accident, I learned about data science, trying to do my final essay. I had some protein sequences to analyze, and I wanted to find the sequence of each amino acid in sequences, and I tried to do it with R. And I realized I was trying to do something like data science. Mm-hmm. I started to watch YouTube videos. I found Kenji. Mm-hmm. I became part of the 66 days challenge. Mm-hmm. And now I'm learning Python. I didn't know where to start. And I started on Kaggle learning Python. And I have almost finished the course on Kaggle.
Oh, awesome. The entire thing? So Python, pandas, visualization, intro to machine learning?
No, only Python.
Oh, okay. Well, that's a fantastic foundation. I love your story. It's very similar to Data Professor. He also comes from a bioinformatic background. So you went from R into Python, and now you've almost finished the Kaggle course. Yeah. So in the beginning, what were your questions about starting to learn data science? Like, you probably wanted to know what kind of language to learn first, or what kind of methods to learn. How did you get them answered on YouTube?
Yes. The first question I had is what language to learn.
Okay.
I had a short background on R, because I tried to find out some more details on R due to my final essay in university.
Okay.
And also a professor of us introduced us to R, like something new, a new language for biotechnologists to use. So I had a small introduction on that. And then I watched the videos, yours and Kenji's, saying that no matter what language you choose, it's okay. So why I passed from R to Python only by chance, the first day of data of the challenge, I tried to open an EDX course on R, but for some reason I couldn't start the course. So I said, okay, I leave up R. Let's see what Python is about. Now it's the time. My luck shows me another way. So I started Python. KP seems a very good platform, and I started like that way.
Awesome. Do you like Python more now, now that you've had a little bit more experience?
I like R, but Python helped me understand a lot of things on objects like and the variables, I think it's the right word.
Yes.
And on how the basics of programming, I think. R was a little bit easy for me, so I started with commands on tables, on graphs, and I didn't have a background on basic programming like loops and strings.
I have a question. So when you started moving from bioinformatics to more data science related work, what are your goals now in terms of finding a job in data science or working in Greece versus the US versus some other part of the world? What would be your future goal in terms of career, not since you're a student currently?
I'm a senior student, so I'm starting to getting into the thoughts of my career.
Yes.
I would be very happy if I could do data science on biological data.
Yeah.
So my goal is to refresh my statistics and build my programming skills, and finally do data science on biology subjects.
Okay, that's awesome. Do you want to continue to work in Greece, or do you want to work somewhere else?
I would like to stay in Greece.
Okay.
If I could do a long distance work, like staying in Greece and work for a company abroad, it would be nice to.
Yes, the world is getting a lot smaller, and remote work seems to be the case for everybody here. Almost, I have at least half of my friends moving away, which is kind of interesting because they only plan to leave for the end of the year, maybe half of next year, because who knows the uncertainties in the world right now. But yes, remote work is really easy right now. How are you applying to jobs at the moment? Like, are you still looking into internships or academic opportunities, or are you going on LinkedIn, Glassdoor, and other job aggregation places like that?
I haven't applied. That's a bad story, but I haven't applied yet for a job.
Gotcha.
I would like to do it. I would like to do it, but I haven't. How do you propose to start?
Yeah, I will send you some resources because the main point of creating a LinkedIn network is so that when recruiters are using their search engines, because they're trying to automate that process so that they don't have to manually try to find every viable candidate, they will be able to pick up your profile with some search engine optimization, right? You want to be able to have enough connections, one, which is a big feature in that model, but at the same time, you want to also be able to start building a creative space for your thoughts and your posts. So LinkedIn is kind of, LinkedIn in 2020 is basically YouTube in 2016 or 2018, where there's a lot of creators are already there, but it's very easy to grow and start building a profile. So I guess supposedly it's starting to become like Facebook, where people just start posting random stuff. But you can still build very informative pieces, especially since you have a niche in bioinformatics. You can post about your biology data sets and other things that you've connected with, maybe in Data Professor's channel and his resources. The second thing is, I really recommend getting an AngelList profile, which is a website that connects you with smaller companies, but they can still range from anywhere from less than 10 people to more than 200 people. So these companies need to outsource their HR and recruiting efforts to this company, which allows you to have an easy head start when putting your resume to the top. Also, if you've ever used LinkedIn's Easy Apply feature, on AngelList, every single job is Easy Apply. So it takes very little of your time and it has big results. In fact, I've gotten a job on AngelList.
Great.
Yeah, that's a lot of information, but I'll send you an email with all of it later so that you have it all. But in terms of the next steps from standing out for data science role specifically, I think it would be great to start working on a project where you scrape your own data. And that might be more difficult for biology-based data sets, because financial data sets, I'm actually going to come out with a video soon, or maybe I've already come out with it, with, you can get New York Stock Exchange data from a pandas library in less than 3 lines of Python. So that's something that is already exists in the real world. And of course, HR and Glassdoor data is already exists in the real world. Biology data sometimes has a paywall or some sort of difficulty in terms of scraping. But I would recommend, Kenji has a great playlist on building that out from end to end. And I can send you that, unless you've already watched it. It's where he scrapes some Glassdoor data.
I have watched a part, but I'd like to re-see it.
Yes, and like Kenji says, building projects out is the best way to learn. You start building a project, you have the reasoning behind learning more skills. And so starting a YouTube channel was a big reason why now I know how to edit videos, I know how to be more patient and slower in my public speaking. It ends up being a project in each specific video. And so that's just like my next step in the data science world, I suppose.
I think I'm a beginner. I don't know if I could do a whole project, but as soon as I start, is the better.
Yes. And I'm happy to walk you through in case you had any questions on the code as you start that project or start any kind of project similar to that. I think that would be really helpful since you're starting your last year of school. This is the time to have a capstone project, a pinnacle project in your pocket when you talk to recruiters. If I may, I would like to open it up to any questions you might have at the end of this call, like anything that you are curious about or any kind of resources I can point you to. I'm happy to answer any questions about the data science world or about Data Leap or about myself.
So I'm finishing the Python part on Cake.
Yes.
What can I do next, except from a project on some data?
Great question. So I outline what to do next after the Python Kaggle course on my $0 Data Science Bible video with Data Professor. I write out exactly what you do for the first 7 days of your data science journey, which is the Python Kaggle course. And then for the next 14 days, there's the data visualization and the pandas courses on Kaggle. That is a good foundation because it builds directly on the Python you've already learned. And then you move on to intro to machine learning and advanced machine learning methods on the same Kaggle course. If you've completed that entire Kaggle course, I would start building out your SQL and Python algorithmic training, which you can find on LeetCode and HackerRank for free. And I'm happy to send you those resources as well. If you can do one LeetCode or one HackerRank question a day, that'll really help you start building out your skills in terms of drilling the speed at which you answer these questions. Because ultimately, employers and technical interviewers are going to be looking for how fast you can answer these pretty mundane logical questions, which means that they're not going to be relevant to your job, but they are going to be relevant to whether you get the job. So that's why you have to start training your SQL and Python speed ASAP.
Okay, great. Thank you.
No problem. Any other questions?
I want also to refresh my statistics knowledge. Do you have some platform to propose for this?
That's a great question. So in terms of statistics, I would say being able to understand the very basic of Bayesian statistics, ending causation and correlation, how linear regression differs from logistic regression, and then a couple of more models would be essentially all the statistics you need. But if you want to prepare for a more advanced role, like a research scientist role, like a machine learning engineer role, then you could go on to one of my favorite data scientists in the world, which is Andrew Ng. So Andrew, same as my name, but NG is his last name. And he creates these really great, easily followable machine learning and statistical math explanation videos. And so he explains them at the very advanced levels, but also from the ground up so that anybody can follow along with them. Yes, Andrew NG, like Gary, like Greece. Yes, Andrew Ng, perfect.
I think I don't have any more questions. Thank you very much.
No problem. I want to be updated on your progress. So Rhea, thank you for joining me. I'm really appreciative. I'm going to have you be the very first person that I upload as part of this community initiative of learning who you are, what your journey is all about, and hopefully a lot of people can learn some interesting tidbits from the questions you've asked. And I want you to continue reporting back maybe in a couple of weeks about where you are, and let's get you a job when you graduate this year.
Perfect. Thank you very much.
You can contact me at any time. I owe you an email, so I'm going to send you all those resources I talked about, and then we'll get in touch soon. Don't be a stranger. I'm really fast on replying on YouTube, and then the second fastest is Discord, and then the third fastest is like email or something.
Great. Awesome.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
No problem. Have a good day. Bye-bye.
Are you still there? To delete this message, press 7. To save it in the archive, press 9. To hear more options, press 0.
What are you talking about?